Hi, this is Rori, and today's tip is what to do if he's not listening to you, if he's not even hearing you, if you don't feel like he's part of the conversation with you. This actually has a name. It's called conversational narcissism. Now, it doesn't mean he's a narcissist. It doesn't mean we're labeling him as a kind of a person. But in conversation with you, he only is talking about himself. He has to work really hard and be coached by you to actually listen to you and to then ask you questions and be in conversation with you. Now, if this is something that he seems to do with everybody, please again consider whether or not this man is the right man for you, because you're never going to feel got. You're never going to feel heard. However, it might just be an immaturity. It might be something he never learned, and you can teach him. So what you do is this. He's talking about himself. You listen to him. And we'll do that tip again in another day of the sequence. You listen to him. You just stand there and you focus on him. Relax, lean back, hear him, nod your head, ask questions. Like, wow, what's important about that? Wow, that sounds icky. Oh, how awesome. What happened then? And then you see what he does. Does he say anything about you? Does he say, and how was your day? And how did it go with you? If he doesn't, then you go, I have some stories that would feel great to talk about. And, oh, you can hear the gardeners next door. He's being a conversational narcissist. No, it's all about him. These are the sounds that happen outside when you're filming outside. But for me, it's real life. This is grounded in what real life is rather than a presentation. It's me living my life sort of in front of you and explaining and demonstrating how I make this work, how my clients make this work, how coaching makes this work, and how you can make it work. So when somebody is not hearing me and is only talking about themselves, I can shut down and just never want to talk to them again. Or I can say, this great thing happened to me today. It would feel great to share it with you. See what he says. He might go, oh yeah, yeah, yeah. So you start talking and you feel whether it's falling on deaf ears or whether he's trying to listen, and you kind of then stop and give him a moment, a space to interact with you. Now he's got to say something like, oh, what next? Or that's weird, or try to fix it. Anything that's in response to what you were talking about. And if he doesn't, and if he can't, now you have to have the conversation. The conversation is, hi, honey, I just love being with you. You're so interesting. I just enjoy talking with you so much. And sometimes I don't feel quite heard, or I'm not sure that I feel like you're interested in me, that I'm interesting to you. And you'll go, what? What are you talking about? If he's a good guy. And you go, I would love to feel like when I talk about something that there's interest. I would love to hear a question. I would love to hear you help me kind of explore what's going on with me. You'll go, well, what does that look like? And I'll say, well, sort of like if I say, well, I had a really rough day at work. I would like it if you said, what happened? Tell me about it. And then if I start to tell you, you ask maybe another question. So I feel like we're talking. Now, I realize this sounds like baby stuff, like you're training a child to have a conversation with you. And yet, this is what we all have to do, we women. We have to train men how to touch our bodies. We have to train men how to hear us. We have to train men how to pay attention to us. And there are many different ways to do it. One thing you can do is tune out completely, step away, go cold, ignore him. In this situation, that would not work. You want to go with the other side, which is telling the truth, opening up, letting him know how you feel, and giving him direction. If he's open and if he says, tell me what to do, then you are being instructed to give him direction. So here's how to get a man to hear you. Don't just sit and pretend it's okay. You'll be miserable. Don't just live with it. Notice if you feel in your heart that you're not being heard.